Hey beauties, and welcome back to I Am Beautiful Hustler TV. Today I'll be showing you guys a quick weave leave-out tutorial on natural curly hair. And today's hair is provided by Stumber Hair. They sent me 4 bundles of body wave in inches 20 through 26. So that's 20, 22, 24, and 26. And today I'll be doing a quick weave installation on my client today. And I'm going to show you guys exactly how to use my Glam Wax Stick to blend your natural leave out with any type of straight or body wave hair or any curl pattern hair, really, to be honest, just using, you know, different types of techniques for whichever kind of hair you are using. But I will be showing you how to use it today on body wave hair. So I hope you guys do enjoy this tutorial. Stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe. Now, first things first, I showed you guys the braid pattern in the beginning of this video. I have my 2 braids that I have for the leave out hanging down outside of the cap. And because this will be like a pushback behind the ear, the braid, I did leave out some of the hair on the side, which you guys will understand more once I actually cut the cap off and you see my leave out section. But I went ahead and applied both of my stocking caps. I put the light one underneath and the black one on top, but usually you will use 2 black stocking caps for quick weaves. So now that I went ahead and sewed my cap all around that leave out as well and all around the back, I'm just going to go on with my pump it up spritz and just spray that all over the caps before I begin to bond in the tracks. Now, when you are bonding in different length bundles, you always start with the longest bundle first and you bond that at the bottom. And I'm actually double wefting my tracks as I glue them in. And I actually have a full detailed tutorial on how to double, how to double weft your quick weave bond-ins. That way you can fit more bond-ins in, and it will also save you time on doing a full quick weave installation. Now, in real life camera time, this took me about 35 minutes to do this full style. But of course, with editing and, you know, cropping out things, you know, this video is just, you know, a little bit faster than the full length process. But I'm just going to continue to bond my tracks up all the way to the top. And I'm using a Salon Pro 30 second glue to, you know, bond the tracks in. As far as bonding glue, you can use a 30 second pro or the regular bonding adhesive. It really doesn't matter, but just like never ever use any lace glue to do your bond ins. So just to give you guys a quick tip, whenever you want to do a pushback, a quick weave, and also like a pushback where the hair comes over the ear, not like an actual spritz back pushback, and if you want the hair to fall into your face, for the pushback part, it's a certain place where you have to stop the tracks, and I will be able to explain that more to you in detail once I cut off the extra cap. But if you want the hair to fall on your face, make sure you are curving of those tracks somewhat in a C motion, and that will get the hair to fall in your face and, you know, be, you know, fuller looking versus you just bonding the tracks like straight back. As you can see, I'm curving those tracks at the top to fall into the face, and once I get enough tracks curved, I will begin to straighten the tracks back up, meaning bonding them, you know, just kind of like straight forward and back. But right here, what I'm doing now is cutting off the extra cap from around the leave out. But be sure to pick that cap up before you actually, you know, cut it. That way you do not cut your client's real hair or braids. But now that I have this cut off, you can see how I sectioned out my leave out. I did the regular section to cover the tracks on the side where the hair was falling in the face. But to create that natural pushback, I did leave some of the leave out on the sides, as you can see there, and I stopped the tracks before it got to that leave out area. That way, when I take the braider loose and hot comb and press it out, the hair will fall on top of the tracks versus me spritzing that area back and then gluing the tracks on top of it. So when you want to create soft looks, that's the way you can do your pushbacks as well. But even though I am doing the pushback on here, I'm still going to use spritz because she did want it to last a little bit longer, especially for the holidays and everything like that. So that's just a key to achieving that natural pushback look, is how you section out the leave out and where you stop your tracks. So now I'm going to go ahead and add my lash track around, and with this lash track, I am going to single it so it lays very, very flat and you don't get like that line of demarcation on your quick weave, which is where you could kind of see the dent of where the track starts under your leave out, and you do not want to see that dent. So I'm going to single out that lash track, and you want to bond it as close to your leave out section as possible. So now that I have all of the tracks bonded in, I'm gonna go ahead and just take my comb and just quickly comb those bundles out. I've worked with Summer Hair before, and I actually love their bundles and closure that they sent to me, and they sent me some body wave hair once again. And of course, I love this hair. So now I'm gonna show you guys in detail how to press out natural leave out, how to blend it, and also how to correctly use my Glam Wax stick. And just a reminder, this will release on January 1st. They are $10, so get ready to make your purchases. And I will also have a coupon code for my first few buyers. As like a little, you know, New Year's giveaway treat type of thing. But nevertheless, I'm just going to take my time and I'm just combing out their leave out before I begin to add my glam wax. So here it is. As you guys can see, I've used it in my most recent videos, and I'm just going to apply that wax at the roots and also towards the ends of the hair. And I'm going to flat iron this hair piece by piece. Now, I will be using my 1-inch flat iron. So right now I'm just going to focus on this first little section here. And I'm just going to take that same little piece that I grabbed and split that in two. And using my flat iron, I'm going to do the chase method and just stretch out the hair with the comb and just go behind it with my flat iron and press it out. And as you can see, just after those first strokes, that hair is silky and that hair is straight. So I'm just going to repeat the same exact steps with my flat iron to press all of that leave out, and just make sure you get as close to the roots as possible, that way your roots are straight as well. And that's pretty much how you use the wax stick. So now I'm just going to go ahead and continue to press out the leave out some more. Now I'm trying to like press the leave out in a direction that it will fall, and also in a direction where you I would not burn her ear or anything like that. So that's why some directions I'm going up and down, and then when I'm flat ironing the hair, going, you know, towards the direction it's going to fall, just to, you know, I just be careful around the ear to make sure that I do not burn her. And I just go through that pieces of hair at least twice, three times at most, and I will repeat these same exact steps to the top part of the leave out. once again, you just want to take that wax stick, apply it all over the roots and the ends of the leave out, and then just grab section by section using the chase method to press it out. So now that the leave out is pressed out to my liking, I'm gonna go ahead and just perfect my part. I wanted my part to be kind of curled because how I want to do the placement of my baby hair. So I'm just going to like perfect that little, just a slight C curve, not too much of a big C, but just like a slight C, and everything that I'm combing down will be swooped for baby hair. So now I'm just gonna take my Pump It Up spritz and apply it at the top area of the leave out, and I'm just going to take my hand, my comb, my hot comb, and my blow dryer as well on the heat setting and just smooth and lay those hairs down until it is completely flat and neat. Hey, what's good, Shikari? And now I'm gonna go in with my hot comb and just really hit the roots to get it really, really nice and straight, because with leave out, neatness is everything. So you want to make it look as flat and as neat as possible, especially if your client was natural. You don't want it to make it seem like they were natural, like you still wanna give off that relaxed hair effect. So now I'm going to take my Beautiful Hustler Glamorous Edges Edge Control, and I will be relaunching this edge control later on, probably like in March around my birthday time, so stay tuned for that. I'm working on an even stronger and better product. So right now I'm using the original formula, and I'm just creating my baby hairs just by using my edge brush and the edge control, just creating like C's and then just dragging that baby hair to create like the little line part creases in between, and just using my fingers to just smooth all of that out. And because her sideburns are long, I'm just going to do like a C, like a snake motion to create those sideburns, and then I'm just going to comb and smooth everything out. Now, a new thing that I do with my leave out now, before I used to just, you know, do the black spray method and that's it to clean up the part. But some people might find it weird, but I actually like to do this. Not only do I conceal the parts on my wig, but I like to conceal the parts with my leave out as well. And it just makes it look even cleaner and even neater, the same way it would on a lace wig. So you will see me after smoothing out the edges and the hair and everything and applying the black spray, I will go in with her skin tone foundation and conceal her natural scalp, her natural scalp part, and it will make it just like pop even more. But before I do that, I'm just going to continue to comb and just smooth everything out, make it nice and neat. And because her hair is long, it kind of like blends in with the Body Wave hair already, so no need to go in and one curl. But now I'm just going to take that black spray, like I mentioned, and go in with that concealer. And just look how clean the part starts to look once I start defining it. And that's why I really love this concealer method on wigs and on leave-out. But this pretty much sums up this tutorial. I pretty much brought to you how to do the quick weave, the push behind the ear leave out, and also how to properly use my Glam Wax Stick. So make sure you check the description box down below to purchase my products and get ready to buy it on January 1st. And once again, this hair was by Somber Hair, their Body Wave. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and stay tuned for more videos.